Renee Hale, and my husband tends to be the one who does these dictations, but lately I felt compelled to do the same. Wyatt has suffered long enough. Ever since we gave him the Sorrowvirus, death has been absolutely nothing but a temporary solution for him. I wondered if we could alter the Sorrowvirus, but Caleb told me we can't modify it due to what happened to his sister when he was younger. It changed her drastically. She's still out there, somewhere.
It's easy to lose track of time in a timeless place. I need to keep checking in with those clocks whenever I can. Leaving it for too long will cause me to age quickly. Leaving it forever will do something far worse. I need a lighter. Thank you.
Why did you kill me?
We've sent Roscoe Heller to go and look for him, for Wyatt's cousin. I'm curious to see if he'll be interested to help us after all these years. Wyatt keeps seeing his cousin's name in purgatory, or at least a jumbled version of it, and I don't know why. I have all the answers he could need, and if he chooses to help us, I'll tell him everything he wants to know. He's never met Wyatt before.
I should have known he'd try to get involved. He doesn't even know Wyatt. He just can't leave us alone. He has to interfere. Roscoe? Heller?
You need me, Caleb.
Yes, I want you to find this man.
Why this guy?
Because it's your job and we're paying you.
Not right now. There's too much.
Roscoe! He killed your sister. I thought so.
I miss you, Madeline. I'll not let what happened to you happen to Wyatt. We will never modify the Sorrowvirus again. I'm sorry that you're still there, but you're safe. You're comfortable. I hope. I will see you again after we've completed our research. Why do I bother with this sentimental drivel? It only holds me back.
Cousin will be here soon. Hold on. Just hold on.